Hello everyone, in this class of business finance we will be discussing few of the topics. The topics that we are going to cover in this session are cash flow, payback period method, accounting rate of return, net present value and internal rate of return. Basically these methods are most important techniques used in capital budgeting. So first of all, I will just give a little brief about what capital budgeting is. Capital budgeting is basically allocation of capital for various projects. Like whenever a business is trying to invest in a certain project, then they have to evaluate the overall worth of the project in relation with the amount of investment that is going inside the project. So for evaluating the project in the financial terms, then there are few techniques which are used, and all those techniques that we are going to cover in this session. So starting with the first technique, that is whenever we are talking about investment, then investment always considers the amount of the cost involved in putting the capital and the amount of return that it is going to generate in the future. So the ratio or the differential between the outflow and inflow will suggest or will give a direction for making the decisions whether the project is acceptable or whether it is going to generate value for the business. So cash flow are very important for a business to consider. Whenever a business is trying to invest in a project, so the cash outflow takes place. So outflow of cash means it is considered as the investment that is being made by the business by arranging the capital sources from various avenues. Like some businesses, they arrange from the debt market, some can arrange from the equity or share market, and other options are also available which are considered as institutional finance or promoter's own capital. So when we're talking about cash flow, then cash flow is coming from various sources, and it is very important for a business to consider the various projects in which it is going to invest or it is going to select from the options that are available for the business. Now what kind of business we are talking about and what kind of investment proposal is there has to be evaluated based on the techniques that we are going to follow in this session. So cash flow becomes very important for a business to consider, because cash flow is going to provide the details about whether the project is going to generate the positive cash flow in relation with the amount of initial investment that a business has made in the project. For example, if a business is making 1000 crore of the investment, initial investment in any project, then it has to evaluate whether that 1000 crore investment is going to be recovered by the project in the future through the cash inflows, and how much time it is going to take for recovering that amount of capital. So that this cash inflow and outflow situation at the time of investment becomes very critical. Then comes payback period. Payback period is a basically technique. It is a method that is used by the businesses to evaluate the projects as to whether those projects are going to generate enough cash flows, cash inflows, that can help them recover the initial investment in shortest time possible. Like for example, if there are two projects X and Y, and both these projects have initial investment of 1000 crore. Now the first project is giving the returns for 5 years, and the second project is giving the returns for 5 years. Now if the first project is generating enough cash flows, and within third year 1000 crores is being recovered, and the fourth project is recovering the cash inflows of 1000 crore in 4 years, then the first project, which is recovering the 1000 crore in 3 years time, is going to be accepted as per the payback period time, because payback period means the amount of time that a project is taking for recovering the initial investment under a certain terms and conditions. So payback period method becomes very important for several businesses and projects based on the nature and circumstances. Then comes accounting rate of return. So accounting rate of return is basically बेस्ड ऑन अ कैलकुलेशन मेथड, इट इज़ अ परसेंटेज रेट ऑफ रिटर्न एक्सपेक्टेड ऑन अ इन्वेस्टमेंट. फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द एसेट्स कंपेयर टू इनिशियल इन्वेस्टमेंट कॉस्ट. फॉर एग्जांपल, द अकाउंटिंग रेट ऑफ रिटर्न फार्मूला डिवाइड्स द एवरेज एसेट्स एवरेज रेवेन्यू बाय द कंपनीज इनिशियल इन्वेस्टमेंट. दैट मीन्स द अमाउंट ऑफ रिटर्न्स दैट अ प्रोजेक्ट इज गोइंग टू गिव ओवर इट्स लाइफ टाइम and its average is being taken. Now that average is being divided by the initial investment. For example, a project's initial investment is 1000 crore and its average return is like, for example, 1200 crore. So when we divide 1000 by 1200, then the figure that will be generated will be considered as accounting rate of return in percentage terms. Now, in percentage terms, it is going to give us the information regarding as to whether the project is going to generate positive cash flows or whether it is making any sense, because accounting rate of return method is based on the data from the accountancy or the data that is generated in the business account. So this method is going to provide some information as to whether the project is going to generate the rate of return that a business is evaluating, or whether it should focus on something else. So this method is also used by several businesses in order to evaluate whether they are making the right investment before making the investment, and this method is considered as one of the mostly widely used methods in the businesses that have the products which are of basic use, which are not innovative type products. So in that category, the past data or the data that is available in the market is going to help the businesses in making the decisions. So accounting rate of return method becomes very important in calculating the worth of a project in terms of its return generation capabilities. Then comes net present value. Net present value method is one of the most important method in capital budgeting techniques. This method is basically based on the discounting principle. Like, discounting means whenever we are talking about finance, then investments are made for future, and whenever we are talking about investment, then the amount that is being invested in a particular project or investment is being done in present circumstances. So if we are investing in a project in today's market conditions, in today's market value, in today's monetary terms, then the returns from the project will be generated on the future value terms. So the value of the money over a period of time reduces, its buying power reduces based on time value of money method, as we know in the earlier session we had talked about it. So whenever we are talking about the reduction in the value of the money, then the investment's expected returns will also be reduced over time. So whenever a business is trying to invest in a project, it has to consider whether the project is going to generate positive return in the future. And by talking about positive return, that means in present terms. Like, for example, a project whose returns are very favorable, like we are seeing that in future this project, if we invest 100 crore in the project, it will give us 150 crore in 5 year times. Like, within 5 years this project will give 150 crore. Now 150 crore is a very good amount, like 50% returns this project is giving us in 5 years time. Now if we see within 5 years the value of the money will decrease, and if we take 10% decrease in the value of the money over every year, then this project over the 5 year time will lead us to no profit no loss like situation. So that's where the discounting method come into practice. Like in NPV method, we reduce the value of the future cash flows by applying the discounting rate. That discounting rate is signified by the reduction in the value of the money over a period of time. So that is called टाइम वैल्यू ऑफ मनी मेथड एंड बेस्ड ऑन द फिगर्स दैट वी गेट द प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ अ प्रोजेक्ट्स रिटर्न्स वी मेक द डिसीजन इन द बिजनेस वेदर द प्रोजेक्ट इज सूटेबल और नॉट. देन कम्स इंटरनल रेट ऑफ रिटर्न. इंटरनल रेट ऑफ रिटर्न मेथड इज बेस्ड ऑन नेट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू डिस्काउंटिंग टेक्निक. सो इन इंटरनल रेट ऑफ रिटर्न वट वी डू इज वेन एवर अ बिजनेस इज ट्राइंग टू इन्वेस्ट इन अ प्रोजेक्ट इट इज इवेल्युएटिंग द मिनिमम पॉसिबल रेट ऑफ डिस्काउंटिंग इन विच द बिजनेस विल गोइंग टू गेट द मिनिमम रेट ऑफ रिटर्न फ्रॉम दैट इन्वेस्टमेंट. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ बिजनेस इज इन्वेस्टिंग 100 करोड़ नाउ आफ्टर 5 ईयर्स इफ इट विल गेट 150 करोड़ नाउ इट इज taking 10% as discounting rate. So applying 10% discounting rate, it is getting 100 crore of the 100 crore of the future returns in present terms. So this 100 crore is going to be the basis of evaluating the internal rate of return percentage. Like if 10% discounting rate result in giving us 100 crore of initial investment, then this 10% will be IRR. So IRR method is based on trial and error method. So a business has to apply different discounting rates in order to arrive at a point where they are having no profit, no loss situation, so that they can take it as a parameter for evaluating the various projects for investment purposes. So thank you for this session. Have a nice day.